This is unboxing and a short review of a Rosewill Challenger mid-tower case. I have to mention that Rosewill is a Newegg's house brand, and it's, I don't think it's available anywhere else besides Newegg.com. It comes with this in this plain brown press paper box, and I have to mention that all of the Rosewill cases are fairly cheap, and this one was $45. I already took it out of the box. Ta-da! Alright, what's in the box is this case and the standard user's guide. The user's guide has your usual how-tos, installations, and your front input-output pin definitions. This case is really not that heavy. It's about, I think, 6 kilograms. It's all steel construction with some plastic parts. It has this piano black shiny plastic front. It has this power button, the reset button, power LED, looks like red. Your headphone jack, your microphone jack, your two USB 2.0 ports, and one eSATA port. In the front, you got three 5.25-inch bays for optical drives or fan controllers, whatever. It still comes with the three and a half inch bays. I don't know really who still uses floppies, but you may install a memory card reader or a small fan controller here. So it's nice. This perforated bezel is perfect for the airflow, and behind this bezel they included the foam dust filters. Here on the side panel there is space for two optional fans. These two cooling fans cool CPU and the video card, which are most heat intensive parts in the system. And the options here are 80mm, 92mm, and 120mm fans, whichever you may prefer. Let's take the side panel off. This case comes with four thumb screws, but these screws are not your regular all-metal thumb screws. It's actually regular metal Phillips screws embedded in the plastic head. So be careful with your screwdriver. I prefer if you use the, just your thumbs, your fingers. Let's take off this panel here. Okay. As you see inside the panel and inside the case, everything is painted black, which is, you know, it's good. Many people prefer painted inside, and also it's painted in the back here, so it's all out black. What we have here is rubber power supply bracket, and it's sticky, so I imagine you can go ahead and stick it in the back so it kills the power supply vibration. These are your input output front panel cords. It comes with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 PCI slots. They all perforated, ventilated, and what I like, they actually come with screws, not those toolless plastic little hinges. Because if you got some heavy, expensive video card, you know, I don't trust those plastic toolless ones. This is an accessory bag. Okay, here's an 8 doing in a half inch drive brackets. So it's a toolless design, really. You just slap them on the side of your hard drive and slide it inside this hard drive cage here. Also what's in the bag is your standard bag of screws and the motherboard standoffs and the little motherboard speaker. What's nice about this case is that all the screws and even the screws on the PCI bracket, they are all covered black. They are black anodized screws. Also inside the hard drive cage, they included a 2.5 inch hard drive cage for your SSD, and it's actually plastic. I mean, it's not, I mean, it's cheap. What'd you expect? Okay, these are for tools, you know, installation of your optical drives. So you have little signs here, lock and unlock. So all you do is you insert your optical drive and you lock it and it stays in place. This case comes with some decent air cooling features. It has a blue LED fan right here in the front of the case, which is taking air straight through this ventilated bezel. It comes with a 140mm fan on the top pre-installed, with an option to swap it out for 120mm fan. And it comes with 120mm fan in the back pre-installed, with an option of either 92 or 80mm fan. This case actually has, I think it's 1/8 of an inch water cooling holes with rubber grommets. What else can I say about here? Oh, here's a space for your input-output motherboard panel. Oh, here in the bottom, can you see? Can you zoom in? Here in the bottom, they have a perforated space for your power supply intake. When the power supply facing down, it can draw air from the bottom here. And also what they did, they included a removable power supply filter. Let's see how removable it is. So when this thing gets dusty, you can just like wash it off, or you know, vacuum it or blow through it with a air can. On the bottom you have 4 rubber feet, which helps against vibration or prevents you from scraping the surface. What doesn't hurt, though, if they would include a space for another fan here, some cases come standard with a hole for 120mm fan. This one did it, but it's easily can be modded. You can just cut a hole here yourself. Also, they included here your power supply. It stands on these 4 little rubber feet, so it doesn't scratch itself against the case here on the bottom. And the last but not least, let's see the other side. All right, I did it. This is a space behind the motherboard, and for those people who are worried about cable management, be worried, because there's not much space behind the motherboard at all. There's maybe, this is not even a centimeter of space here, maybe 6-7 millimeters of space between the motherboard tray and the back cover. So if you got a lot of these fat power supply cables, you're probably gonna have to spread them around in this area, or just, you know, lay them out carefully. Also, the motherboard tray comes with a large CPU cutout, so you can replace your third-party CPU coolers without taking out your motherboard. It has a lot of holes here for wire management, also a lot of these zip tie supports, and this is pretty much it. This has been a review of a Rosewill Challenger case. I appreciate the comments, and if you like to see more of my videos, please subscribe and thank you.